My dear friends, I am very pleased to see your smiling faces. At least they look like faces to me. Yes, I think so. I am sorry that the weather has kept away all our best people. Well, here we are with a jolly good Christmas party in front of us. Not only is this Boxing Day, but the coming of age of my eldest son, in honor of which he has presented us with this Christmas tree dug from my garden. At school, he was the cleverest boy who never won a prize. His master once said to him, "Foster, that's the fourth time you've looked over the next boy's paper." And he said, "Yes, sir, he writes so badly." But we are not here to talk of my son, but of the tree and the gifts which hang from its branches. Lots of Santa Claus stockings, all in up-to-date network. Knit one, slip one, purl one. As I have lately had all new cowls put up, how he got down the chimney, I don't know. Here we have lots of animals, made of rubber and blown with air. Blue elephants, pink gee-gees. I am told that if you prick them, they will cry. Something's bound to happen anyway. Yes, I think so. Good gracious, this is a big parcel. 12 consecutive monthly numbers of our parish magazine, all uncut. Great excitement. Don't forget that you've all got an equal chance of securing these. You will draw your numbers from that bran tub, which has no bran in it, but I have been promised some for next year. Here's another book, How to Become a Football Referee. With this is given away a pair of crutches, 2 eye shades, and a dozen crepe bandages. I invited a lady to come tonight. She was so excited that she dipped into her handbag, took something out, and quickly changed color. We used to say, "Gentlemen, you may smoke," but we now say, "Gentlemen, you may puff, and ladies, you may powder." Upon my soul, here's another book, How to Become an Actor. This will be very useful to anyone who knows how long he can go without food. A gentleman promised to come along tonight with his performing ducks, but as it is Christmas time, he has eaten his artists. Yes, I think so. Ah, my dear friends, does not this Christmas tree tell us of everyday life? We all start laden with the good things of this world, and then they go and give them to other people. Yes, I think so. This tub, in which the roots of the tree are hidden, must remind you of when, as children, you were tubbed and made clean with soap, and how you have washed your hands of it ever since. After the unloading of the tree, we shall have tea and buns. The currents will be on sentry duty at intervals. RSVP, raisins supplied by the vicar of the parish. Then we will have games. I recollect at one party we had some very enjoyable games. Blind woman's buff, posterman's canuck, hunt the kipper, and tiki-tiki-touch wood. And blind woman's buff was very interesting. A lady was blindfolded, she groped around and caught a gentleman. Then she kissed him and guessed his name. And somebody brought in a mop, and the lady kissed the mop. And then she said, "Oh, Mr. Foster, you are wet." Yes, I think so. One of our pastimes will be this. Each person will be permitted exactly 1 minute in which to relate how he or she succeeded in life. I myself shall commence by stating how I landed in a town with only 1 shilling in my pocket, but it gave me a start as I used it to wire home for money. I have 2 little daughters, as you know, Ariel and Crystal, and Ariel dotes on toys. And she said to me the other day, "Daddy, what particular toy are you giving me this Christmas?" I said, "I hadn't thought of it, child." "Daddy," she replied, "I should like a she-bear." A she-bear, my darling. Why a she-bear? Because I'm always thinking of one. When we sing, can a woman's tender care cease towards the child she-bear? And now, dear friends, let us enjoy ourselves and forget all things about rule. Life is one big rule. At school it is all the rule of three. When we are courting, it is a rule of two. And when we are married, assuredly, it is the rule of one. The tide of success ebbs and flows, and nothing recedes like success. By and by, pure bread will be as extinct as the dodo. If you do not believe what I say, send for my bishop, and he will give you confirmation. I declare the party now duly open, and let the fun commence with my blessings on you all.
Yes, I think so.